Dear students, I welcome you all to today's lecture of trigonometry. Wishing you the best time of the day, whichever time you are watching this video. So we are going to do some more basics of trigonometry, and this is going to be part 2. We know by now, we have understood what are the trigonometric ratios: sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosec theta, sec theta, cot theta. And we have understood the formulas which are based on sides, formulas which are based on other trigonometric ratios, and formulas which are based on inverse. Now next, what we have to understand, my dear students, is the values. There are values that certain very important figures, we have to first understand that there are two very important triangles, and at that two important triangles, like this 30 degree, this has to be 60 degree only, and this is 90 degree, 30, 60, 90 degree triangle. And similarly, we will have one more very important triangle, which is 45 90 degree triangle. Okay, my dear student, these are the two triangles, and because considering these two triangles, there are different angles, very important angles. At those angles, trigonometric ratios will have some definite values which you have to by heart, which you have to remember, which you have to logically remember. See, if I start from the lowest figure, 0 degree, we have to know sine 0, cos 0, tan 0, cot 0, sec 0, cosec 0. 0 degree, then 30 degree, then 45 degree, then 60 degree, and then 90 degree. There are in total how many? 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, and then 90 degree. We have to know all the values at these typical angles. When it comes to trigonometry, at these angles, we should know the values of the trigonometric ratios. But before that, my dear students, I will, of course, everybody has their own way of remembering these values. This I find is always the best of all the ways. You have to remember these two triangles. You can imagine these two triangles. Always triangle where this base angle, left hand side the base angle is 90 degree, right hand side the base angle is 30 degree. On top we will have 60 degree. Second triangle where left hand side the base angle is 90 and the other two are 45 45. Now what happens, my dear students, is that here one thing you have to remember: the hypotenuse is always equal to 2, and we have to remember in certain formulas, side opposite to 30 degree is always half of hypotenuse. This is the formula that we have known. Side opposite to 30 degrees always half of hypotenuse. This is the formula. Means what? If supposing the hypotenuse is 200 kilometers, then side opposite to 30 degree will be 100 kilometer. If this is 500 centimeters, so this will be 250 centimeters. Side opposite to 30 degree, side opposite to 30 degree will always be half of the hypotenuse. Whatever is the hypotenuse, half of that. If this is 30 units, this will be 15 units. If this is 10 units, this will be 5 units. So now it is 2 units. So what this will be? 1. And now if you understand, if I apply Pythagoras theorem and solve this, I will get the value of this to be root 3. This is the triangle that you have to remember. 30, 60, 90 degree triangle. Try to understand what I am explaining. See, 30, 60, 90 degree triangle, I hide it. 30, 60, 90 degree triangle will be having the left hand side base angle 90 degree and the right hand side base angle to be 30 degree. This actually I am imagining, my dear students. I am not drawing. You have to imagine this, that a 30, 60, 90 degree triangle will be having left hand side 90 degree, right hand side 30 degree. Now the hypotenuse will be 2. So because the hypotenuse is 2, the side opposite to 30 degree will be 1. And that's why the base, which is the side opposite to 60 degree, will be root 3. If you forget this, you can anytime immediately apply Pythagoras theorem and calculate this. But my dear students, as we go forward, these all things will be fixed in your mind. You don't have to really bother about that. But of course, you'll have to practice it. When it comes to this value, this triangle, 45, 45, 90 degree triangle, then you have to remember these two are going to be congruent sides because they are side opposite to congruent angles. This will be 1 and this also will be 1. If you apply Pythagoras theorem over here, you will get this as root 2. If you remember this, if you are able to remember this, you can now proceed and you can now actually, I'll see 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. I'll take care of these two later. 30, 45, 60, which are major chunk. Let us consider this first. Sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec, cot. See, my dear students, first I'll cover this. You can take anybody arbitrarily, but remember you should be very strong with the formulas. Now let us take tan, or I'll go in a zigzag way. Supposing I start with sec 30. Sec 30. In the question or in some or the other way, you have come across sec 30. Sec 30 is there in your question and you have to know the value of sec 30. Before proceeding to sec 30, you have to immediately be able to visualize two things. First is the triangle, 30-60-90 degree triangle. 30 comes in 30-60-90 degree triangle. So 30-60-90 degree triangle, left angle, left base angle is 90, right base angle is 30, top is 60, hypotenuse 2, this one, and bottom base is going to be root 3. This you should be able to visualize immediately and this happens very fast. Now sec, what is the formula of sec? Hypotenuse upon adjacent. Hypotenuse upon adjacent. 30 is the base right angle. Hypotenuse upon adjacent. Hypotenuse will be 2. Adjacent is the base. Root 3. So it will be 2 upon root 3. See here. 30 degree. Hypotenuse upon adjacent. 2 upon root 3. So this will be sec will be 2 upon root 3. Directly you will get it. You don't have to really form the entire table. You don't have to by heart anything. Okay. Now I go to cosec 45. I purposely am going anywhere. I am going in this zigzag manner purposely. Because when you are solving questions, the trigonometric ratios that are coming in front of you are arbitrarily coming. Anyhow, anyway, any trigonometric ratio will come in front of you. So cosec 45. Cosec 45 means I have to go to 45, 45, 90 degree triangle over where the two sides are 1, 1 and this adjacent, this hypotenuse is going to be root 2. This side is 1, this side is also 1 and this hypotenuse is going to be root 2. I am going to find cosec 45. Whether this is this 45, whether this is this 45, it's not going to bother. But of course you should first see cosec is what? The formula for cosec is hypotenuse upon opposite side. When I consider this, hypotenuse is root 2, opposite side is 1. So it will be root 2 upon 1. So cosec will be root 2 upon 1 is root 2, you don't have to write it. I hope I'm getting clear. See now tan, tan 60. You have to know the value of tan 60. Tan 60 means I will go to the triangle, 30, 60, 90 degree triangle. I hope I'm clear. 30, 60, 90 degree triangle where this is 30 degree, this is 60 degree and this is 90 degree. I am asked tan 60. If 60 is over here at the top. When I see 60, first proceeding further now, I have to visualize the formula of tan. Tan is what? Opposite upon adjacent. opposite upon adjacent. For this 60 degree, this is going to be opposite and this is going to be adjacent. Now, what is that? This is, base is always root 3. This is 1. So tan 60 will be root 3 upon 1. That is only root 3. So tan 60 will be root 3. That's all. 90 degree we'll see later. Okay. So now let's come back over here. Sine 45. I hope you all are getting now. Sine 45. I'm visualizing. I'm not seeing this figure. Sine 45 will be like this. 45, 45, 90. 1, 1 and root 2. 45 I can take this or this. Not going to bother. Sine, but sine is what? Opposite side upon hypotenuse. Opposite side upon hypotenuse. Opposite is 1. Hypotenuse is root 2. So sine 45 will be 1 upon root 2. Sine 45 will be 1 upon root 2. Now I come straight to cos 30 degrees. Cos 30 degree. For cos 30 degree again I will go for 30, 60, 90 degree triangle. 30, 60, 90 degree triangle. Where hypotenuse is 2, this is 1 and this base is root 3. Cos 30 means I have to be over here. Cos 30 means I have to be over here. 30, 60, 90. 2, hypotenuse, this is 1 and the base is root 3. Cos is what? Adjacent upon hypotenuse. Adjacent is root 3 upon hypotenuse is 2. So this will be, cos 30 will be root 3 upon 2. Okay. Now I go to find tan 45. Tan 45 is over here. Tan is opposite upon adjacent. 1 upon 1. 1. Tan 45 is 1. I come to cosec 60. Cosec 60 again I will go in this fashion. 30, 30, 60, 90 degree triangle. Fine. Where hypotenuse is 2. This is 1, this is root 3. 30, 60, 90. Cosec 60. Cosec is over, 60 is over here. Cosec. Cosec is hypotenuse upon opposite side. Hypotenuse upon opposite side. This is 60 over here. Hypotenuse is 2. Opposite to 60 is root 3. 2 upon root 3. Cosec 60 will be 2 upon root 3. So likewise, my dear students, you have to fill in all. Try to make this. Once you understand this, then it is nothing like that. And once you, if this is there in front of you, then nothing is there. Sec 60. 60 is over here. Sec 60 will be, sec is what? Hypotenuse upon adjacent side. Hypotenuse upon adjacent. Hypotenuse is 2. Adjacent of 60 is 1. So this will be 2. Now, cot. Cot 30, this is 30. Cot is what? Adjacent upon opposite side. Adjacent is root 3, opposite of 30 is 1. So it will be only root 3 upon 1, means only root 3. Okay, fine. Now I go to sine 60. I'm just jumping over. Sine 60, 60 is over here. Sine. Sine is opposite side upon hypotenuse. Opposite is root 3, hypotenuse is 2. Opposite side upon hypotenuse, that will make root 3 upon 2. Okay, now I come to cos 45. Cos 45, 45 I can take this or this, not, it's not going to bother. Cos is adjacent side upon hypotenuse, 1 upon root 2. 1 upon root 2. Okay, now I come to sine 30. Oh, I'll come to cot 60. Cot 60, here, 60 degree, cot. Cot is adjacent upon opposite. Adjacent is 1, opposite is root 3, 1 upon root 3. 1 upon root 3, this is cot 60. Okay, now I come to sine 30. Sine 30, 30 is over here, sine is opposite side upon hypotenuse, 1 upon 2. Fine. Cos 60, 60 is over here. Cos is adjacent upon hypotenuse, 1 upon 2. For this, actually, this you have to only have it, have this figure in your brain. You don't have to actually write. If you can write it, it's okay. But once you start doing it, once the exercise is over, one exercise you solve on your own and all these values will fit into your brain. Tan 30 is over here. Tan is opposite side upon adjacent side, 1 upon root 3. Fine. Cosec 30. Cosec is hypotenuse upon opposite side. Hypotenuse upon opposite side, 2 upon 1. Sec 45 is again hypotenuse upon adjacent side, root 2 upon 1. That will make root 2. Fine. Cot 45 is adjacent side upon opposite side, 1 upon 1 will be 1. This way we have done all the trigonometric values, my dear students. Now we have to understand this sine 0 and 90. One thing you have to remember, my dear students, whenever denominator is 0, then this will become not defined. If numerator is 0 and denominator is some value, then the answer is 0. Denominator is 0, it is meaningless, not defined. So first of all, when it comes to sine and cos, you have to remember sine 0 is always 0 and sine 90 is always 1. Sine 0 is always 0, sine 90 is always 1. And exactly opposite happens. Cos 0 is 1, cos 90 is 0. This you have to remember, rest will come on its own. Tan, by formula we know, tan is equal to sine upon cos. Sine upon cos, 0 upon 1, denominator is 1, so this will be 0. This will be sine 90 upon cos 90. Sine 90 upon cos 90 is 1 upon 0, denominator is 0, this will be not defined. Fine. Cosec is always what? Inverse of sine. So cosec 0 will be sine 0 is 0. 0 means 0 upon 1. So cosec 0, I like to inverse this, 1 upon 0, denominator is 0, this will be not defined. But cosec 90, this will be 1 upon 1, if I reciprocate it, it will be still 1. Sec is inverse of cos, this will be 1. This is 0 upon 1, if I reinverse it, it will become 1 upon 0, which is again not defined. Cot is, I can consider inverse of this, 0 upon 1, 0 upon 1, inverse of this will be 1 upon 0, not defined. This is not defined because it is 1 upon 0, that's why it was not defined, 1 upon 0. But if I inverse this, this will become 0 upon 1 and then this will be 0. This will complete the table, this is the table that you have to remember. Of course, there are this multiple other ways to remember this. I find this as the most convenient and most easy way to remember. This is one very important part that we have to remember. And apart from this, my dear students, there are few more formulas that you have to remember. One is basically identities, where actually you have to remember these are the formulas. This will always have square in them. Always remember, my dear students, sine square theta plus cos square theta is always equal to 1. So from this I can get as cos square theta will be what? 1 minus sine square theta. Cos square theta will be, I shift this, 1 minus sine square theta. And also I get sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Remember, this is always plus. You can't have minus over here. You can't have any other operator over here. Neither multiplication nor division. It is only sine square theta plus. This is the basic and most important identity. Like two more identities are there. But because of this identity, these are again created because of only shifting of the terms. Nothing more than that. Second very basic and main idea is 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. Therefore, if I shift this, I will get 1 is equal to sec square theta minus tan square theta. I can't reverse this. If I reverse this, tan square theta minus sec square theta, this will become minus 1. Tan square theta minus sec square theta will be minus 1. Okay? And now, because of this, we have one more, 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. These are the three main identities that you have to remember. So here I will get 1 is equal to cosec square theta minus cot square theta. These are the main identities that you have to remember. Okay, my dear students. So now this is there. What we have understood are the trigonometric values of various angles and these identities. See, my dear students, whenever one thing important, sine 90 minus theta will be equal to cos theta. Sine will get converted to cos. See, you have to be very precise, very generous when we are understanding this. When we did this, sine A, inverse formula we have used, is equal to 1 upon cosec A. Write as sine A is equal to 1 upon cosec A. Or we also can say cos A is equal to 1 upon sec A. Or we can also say tan A is equal to 1 upon cot A. Try to understand these formulas. Here this actually, when it comes to inverse formula, sine is related to cosec, cos is related to sec, and tan is related to cot. And when it comes to identities, sine square, sine will be related to cos square. Tan square will be related to sec square. Cot square will be related to cosec square. But here, there is no change of angles. Sin A will be cosec A. Cos A will be cosec A. Tan A will be cot A. If it is tan A, it has to be cot A. You can't change the angles. Angles have to be specific. They are the sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Means what? Sin square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. I can't take sin square A plus cos square B. No. It is always sin square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. Angles have to be same. Wherever, whichever formulas we have dealt till now, angles are always same. Even if supposing you are changing the trigonometric ratio because of inverse formula, angle is still same. AA. These are the first formulas where to change a trigonometric ratio, angle is also getting changed. Sin 90 minus theta means what? If supposing if it is sin 90 minus B, this will be equal to cos B. 90 minus B is different and B is different. Sin 90 minus theta, but remember, sin 90 minus theta will get converted to cos theta, whatever is this angle. Whatever is this angle. Similarly, cos 90 minus theta will get converted to sin theta. Cosec 90 minus theta will get converted to sec theta. Sec 90 minus theta will get converted to cosec theta. And tan 90 minus theta will get converted to cot theta. Cot 90 minus theta will get converted to tan theta. Only these are loyal pairs. Here too, when they are changing the angles, they are changing with tan cot, tan cot. In inverse also, they are tan cot, tan cot. they change. Sine will get converted to cosec. In inverse, sine will get converted to cosec. Cosec will get converted to sine. But in this quadrantal angles, these are called as quadrantal angles. Quadrantal angles, because 90 minus, if I add these two, they will become a quadrant. So sine, quadrantal angle, sine will get linked with cos. Okay, this you have to understand, my dear student. They are going to play a major role in coming exercises. Okay, so I just hope you all people listen to this video again and again. Try to be solid with your basics over here. And once you have understood these basics, then we can proceed forward to solve exercise 8.2, I suppose. We are into 8.2 now. Okay, so my dear students, go along with this. Stay home, stay safe. Most importantly, stay happy, my dear students. See you all soon. Bye.